Hello everyone, welcome back to Autotrend TV. I am your Viprajesh again and I am here today with the MG Hector Petrol DCT Sharp top of the line petrol variant of the MG Hector range. First of all, on the outside you can see that it has got an all LED setup. You got LED headlamps, LED fog lamps and even daytime running LEDs located up at the top. On the outside at the front you can see that the overall design is nice, it's rich with chrome and it has got a nice aggressive touch to it. MG says that the overall design is inspired by a fighter jet, the F-22, which I kind of have to agree, but on the sides this car has got only 17 inch wheels, which even though being machine cut wheels do not actually suit the overall large proportions of this car. But the good thing is that this car has got really nice build quality. Every metal panel, including the doors, the bonnet and everything, feels really heavy. So I think this would be really a big plus in terms of crash safety. This car has not yet been tested in NCAP crash test though. We are waiting for the results. So next up, you can see that on the sides this car has kind of an MPV-ish look. It is not much of an SUV. It has got a narrow yet long body, which is kind of reminiscent of the Toyota Innova and a Maruti XL6. But it's totally fine. It's got an all-wheel disc brake setup, which is really a big plus when you compare with cars such as the Tata Harrier. Well, another controversial bit is that the rear design overall, it is kind of not up to everyone's taste. The tail lamps are actually LED, which look really nice. But the thing is, both the tail lamps are connected using a red reflector panel, which kind of looks tacky, along with the lower skid plate, which also has kind of a tacky design to it. But okay, it's fine. In this black color, this car looks actually really good on the roads as well as in the showroom. The MG Hector has the pride of being India's first internet connected car. It's got a whole lot of internet connectivity and a whole lot of latest technology. Another slight disappointment is that the MG Hector offers 17-inch 215 section tires, which are suitable for a compact SUV instead of a massive car like the MG Hector. Now coming to the car itself, the MG Hector is actually a rebadged, re-engineered version of the Chinese Baojun 530 crossover, which has been on sale in China and Thailand markets. So now let's have a look at the interiors and the overall features of this 20 lakh rupee tech internet car. Once you get inside the MG Hector, you can definitely notice the amount of efforts gone into this interior to make it look and feel premium. You got leather almost everywhere and you got great amount of tech features such as cruise control and electronically openable tailgate on the top end model definitely. And apart from that, you can feel the richness almost everywhere and it looks kind of sporty in terms of the overall color theme. It's an all black interior but yet looks so very rich. It's got integrated voice commands into the system which can control up to 100 plus functions. And it's got this nice looking semi-digital instrument cluster which looks definitely space age with its blue color. Of course, you get automatic headlamps and wipers as standard on the top end variants. It's got even 6 airbags along with traction control as standard on the top end variants, the electronic stability program being standard from the entry level variant itself. Next up, on the steering wheel, you can notice that on the right side, you get the volume controls along with the Bluetooth connectivity functions with voice command buttons, whereas on the left side, you get the cruise control functions along with the button to control the instrument cluster. On the center console, you get an electronic parking brake function, which is exclusive for the top end automatic variants. This car also boasts of a multicolor interior ambient lighting function. Now, this being the 6-speed DCT automatic transmission, you get even the option of a manual mode. Moving upwards to the center console, you can see that the 10.4 inch portrait touchscreen system takes the center stage on the dashboard. Now this car has got leather upholstery almost everywhere on the dashboard, on the door pads and even on the little center armrest which has an underneath storage. But the problem is the overall quality of this leather is not actually great. In fact, the Tata Harrier's leather feels so much more softer and plusher in comparison. But apart from that, this car has got great levels of connectivity and fancy features. You got even this massive panoramic sunroof, which is actually segment first. It has even got segment first front seats power adjustment. So both the front seats are actually power electronically adjustable. So let's get into the back seat to have a better look at the rear space. Well, the rear seats, as you can see, are folded flat to increase the luggage space, and you can see that how much of luggage space is actually revealed when you actually fold these rear seats flat. The rear seats, as you can see, are 60-40 split and foldable, so it gives a totally flat loading bay. Seriously, large amounts of luggage can also be stored in the boot. Once you get into the rear seats, the space is fantastic. You got great levels of space to stretch out actually, and from the rear seats you can have a good look at the rich looking dashboard design, and the panoramic sunroof definitely adds to the overall ambience of this cabin. But the problem is the rear seats actually lack on thigh support to a certain extent when you compare to the Tata Harrier's rear seats. Now I'll just have a good look at the massive 587 liter boot space of this car. So the trunk is actually electronically openable and even electronically closable too. So that aids the overall convenience of this car. But the little bit of a problem is that the mounts, the hydraulic mounts for the tailgate, even though having such a massively heavy tailgate, are pretty thin, which actually gives me a concern on long-term reliability. Coming to the rear seats itself, it's got the rear AC vents, it's got a nice armrest, and yes, the information is that a 6-seater or 7-seater version is on the way for this car. Once you turn on the infotainment system of this car, you can get to know the whole lot of tech features included into this. It's actually called the iSmart system by MG, which includes up to 100 plus separate voice commands to control various things, and it's even got inbuilt navigation along with Gaana premium app and even other entertainment apps preloaded into this. The highlight is that this infotainment system comes with an 8-speaker Infinity Premium surround sound system, which sounds fantastic. Now, when you actually use this infotainment system while driving, it's seriously useful. On the top-end models, you get a 360-degree surround camera, which actually helps in various conditions. This 360-degree surround camera actually gives you a clear idea of what is actually around you. The quality of the reversing camera could be better though. Once you start driving the MG Hector DCT Sharp Petrol variant, the first impressions are really good. The NVH levels are up to bare minimal levels, and you basically don't get any sort of vibration into the cabin. The next thing being the steering wheel, it is really light, adequately light for city speeds. It is easy to twirl the steering wheel and easy to control the car. But the problem is, once you increase the speed, the confidence may not be up to satisfactory levels. Now, in this short test drive we have experienced, there is not much of a flaw when it comes to the overall driving feel, but we noticed good amount of body roll when you actually turned the car enthusiastically into corners. Yes, the rear seat space is fantastic, and even having three people at the back is definitely a no problem. However, the power delivery, even though being smooth and seamless, there is a minimal level of lag to the DCT transmission once you get off from low speeds. So the actual conclusion on this car's drivability and on-road feel needs to be judged once I have this car for a longer drive. So here we are concluding the short drive review of the MG Hector DCT Sharp Petrol variant. Now the MG Hector Petrol is definitely a good urban crossover, appealing to youthful people who are tech oriented and even to certain families as well. Being India's first internet car, this MG Hector also gives pretty tough competition to the newly launched Kia Seltos, which also has its own set of connectivity features. But all these tech features brings us to one question: reliability. But yes, although not expecting Toyota levels of reliability, the MG Hector actually looks like a pretty reliable car, given that the MG Hector, or namely the Baojun 530, is actually one among the best-selling crossovers in the Chinese market. The positives of this car aside, this car also has its own share of negatives. Mainly, this car, although costing more than 20 lakhs, well, around 20 lakhs, does not feel any kind of an SUV. This MG Hector is actually based on a crossover platform with compact SUV sized wheels. But what the MG Hector Petrol is actually suitable for is urban navigation and highway cruising. You even get a pretty affordable option of petrol, hybrid and automatic variants. Thank you for watching. Do let me know what do you think about the MG Hector Petrol in the comment section below. See you on another video. This is Viprajesh signing off.
Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe for more videos. If you like this video, click the like buttons and give your comments.